Hello everybody, my name is Kate and welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel. I've gotten a health update, I can't talk. I finally got back my results from the biopsy from my liver resection. And what came back was that it was definitely the cancer, that it was the HCC that they said it was. It was two tumors. It was totally removed. So I'm cancer-free. So I'm so glad. I'm cancer-free at this point. You know, I still have the cirrhosis that I have to go to a hepatologist to work on dealing with that, what I need to do to keep that from, you know, from getting any worse. So that's going to be appointment going to be coming up in about probably a week or two. So I just want everybody to know that the pathology report came back and that they completely cleared out the cancer. They said there was no surrounding cells of any of the cancer. They got it all. So anyway, that's great. And they also said that the fatty liver, more likely it's led to the cirrhosis. And the cirrhosis weakens the liver. And I developed the HCC, the cancer. Now, they're telling me that the cirrhosis alone wouldn't have developed the cancer, so they're thinking that it's genetic. So it's genetic why I have liver cancer. My dad died of bladder cancer, or at least what we knew. We didn't know if it started in the liver or not, but he died of bladder cancer. So I'm having my brothers, and you know, I'm going to tell my children, you know, when you go to doctors, tell them that your mom had liver cancer. And they tell me they're pretty sure this is genetic, because the cirrhosis alone, they said, shouldn't have led to the liver cancer. So anyway, that's where I'm at. I'm moving on. Gonna follow up with the liver specialist and just keep doing what I'm supposed to do, it eating right and losing weight. I am doing it. I said, because this was just too much stress, too much to go through, too much to put my family through and friends. So, moving forward, my second chance. So, everything should be good, hopefully, moving forward. All right, what I wanted to show you also today, though, since I'm doing this video today, is I have some recent purchases. Now, you know I moved into this planner, right, to do my health updates and to stay on track. Like I say, here is today's. I've been filling this out. I got six hours and 20 minutes of sleep last night, which was good. I put down my breakfast and lunch. I just ate dinner. I didn't put that down yet. And my carbs and how many steps I wanted to do today. And just so you know, which I am wearing my Fitbit. I love this Fitbit. I've done 7,000, you probably can't see this, but 7,010 steps. Well, I had a goal to do 5,000 steps a day. So I'm very, very happy with that. So I have to keep on increasing that, you know, get up to 10,000 steps a day. So I'm really enjoying this planner. What I'm going to do, after I use it for a little while longer, I'm going to do a review on it. I'm going to do a total review on this planner and go over things that I missed when I first showed it to you, because I was kind of rushed. There was a lot happening that day. So I'm going to go over this planner and go into more detail. So for now, let me just fold her up. Love it. And here's some of my recent purchases. Now, which I know a lot of you watch Miss Vicky B's. I know I've been watching a lot of her videos lately, getting into them more than I used to do it. So, and I've watched some of her planning videos, which she had a lot of different planners. I'm sticking with my two planners right now. But I've also noticed with her that she uses fountain pens. Now, years ago, I guess when I was in high school, it was a long time ago, I tried the fountain pen. Back then, it was really, I mean, it seemed like, I don't know either way I was handling it, or it just was really messy. It seemed like that pen leaked all over me all the time. And, you know, it took a long time for the paper to dry. So I got rid of the fountain pens and just went to ballpoint and then later gel pens. But by watching these videos with these people using these fountain pens, it just brings back the yearning that I had when I used to do the fountain pen, what I really liked about it. It was just something it's just so flowing, such beautiful writing, just looks nice, you know. It's almost like a poetic type writing, I don't know, or artistic type writing that draws me to it. So what I did is, yes, I know what you're saying. Kate, did you buy some fountain pens? Mm-hmm. And I have been writing with one in my planner. Actually, what you've seen in there was written for today was all done by a fountain pen. So let me show you. I went on, it's called Goulet Pen Company. The Goulet Pen Company. I'm going to put it down below, link it down below. I'm not affiliated with them whatsoever. I mean, I just seen it from Miss Vicky B's channel, and I went and looked at it, and they had so much stuff. They're right here in the United States. They're actually based in Virginia. So they're a small company. I'm not sure how long they've been around with, for a few years, maybe 4, 5, 6 years, something like that, but they're a small company. And so I went on their website and started to purchase some things. One thing I purchased was this pen holder, this fountain pen holder. It's leather. I think it's real leather. Don't know. Looks like it. This holds 10 fountain pens, but as you see, I have one in there. See, it holds 10. This is like a velvet. And this right here is called the Lamy Safari. Lamy Safari fountain pen. This is what I've been writing with. It's all plastic. It's very lightweight. It's got a little window there, how much ink you have. Which I don't know if you can see, I have, there we go, I got some ink in there. This fountain pen is the extra fine point. And I'm really enjoying it. And I draw up my own ink. It's not a cartridge in here. It's my own ink. It has a converter on here. Right here. Where you put this into the ink well. And you draw up your own ink. And I absolutely love doing it that way. It came with a cartridge, but I never used a cartridge. But this is called the Lamy Safari, and it's in the neon lime color. Now, I do have some that's actually the metal body, which I think it's called the Lamy All-Star, which I might get one of those too. But this pen writes excellence. I really like it. Okay, so I put it back in my case. And here's the box that came in, the Lamy Safari. Very nice box. This one is called Twisby Mini. Again, if you watch Vicky B, you'll see her. She has a Twisby Mini on there. Let me open this up. Let's see which end do I open. Here we go. These little plastic things come out. Here it is. You see it see-through here, so you can see the ink. And this is a little bit different. You have to unscrew this. Here we go. This is called a nib. The top is called a nib. I'm learning all this. And right here, where the black is the feed. And you turn this, and you put it in the ink well. And then you crank it on back, and it pulls up, it draws up the ink. So it stays in here. This is so nice. And when you go to post it, when you take it off at the top and you put it in the bottom, they call it posting. You screw this in. On this one, you screw into the bottom, and that way you post the pen. Not all of them screw in the bottom. Usually they just push on. But this one screws in top and bottom. And it's called the Twisby Mini, because it's so small. See it in the size next to this one? See, it's the mini. But yet when it's posted, it's as long as this. So that's my second pen. I got one more. I got one, it's called the Cochlin. This, let me get this back in here. I'm trying to line these up. Okay, I want to put my mini in here too. What the heck? There we go. Okay, this is called the Cochlin. There we go. It's in a nice box. And this is an amber. And I think this is a extra fine also. No, this is a fine. This is a fine nib on this one. It's called the amber color. Isn't that pretty? There we go. That's a fine nib, not an extra fine. And this comes with a converter instead of a cartilage. Cartilage. So this is the converter instead of a cartilage. Can't say that one right, can I? Did you wind it on down here? And you suck this one back up like this and it pulls your ink up there. So that's a converter. I can't wait to use this pen. I'm going to use it probably tomorrow. I'll wait for some more inks come in, different colors. So, here's my three pens that I'm starting with. This box away, and along with this I bought some paper. This is like some paper that it's made for writing with a fountain pen. This is called paperforfountainpens.com right there, and this is called Tomoe River Paper. It's very light paper. I did sample of the pens on here. There's the Lamy Safari. Here's my I got a cross pen too. I'm gonna show you that one. And then here is my varsity pen. These are two pens that I purchased. This is from Amazon. You can get these pretty cheap, like for around $10-$12. It's a disposable one. This is good for practicing to see if you even like fountain pens. And then this one, which is the cross, I got this from actually Office Depot, and it was originally came in a pack with some cartridges right here for like $50, but I got it on sale for $20. So there's a cartridge that it comes with. So this does not have a converter in there. You can suck up your own ink, draw it up. So that's basically all my fountain pens that I have right now, which I'm going to put them in here. So I have them all in one place. And this case fits 10, so I have room for 5 more fountain pens. So this is the start of my collection. Like I said, this one right here, the varsity one, is a good starter one because it's disposable. And you can get the fine or extra fine. I got that in the fine, I think it was. Nib, which is the point of how it writes. And I got 3 packs of this river paper, which is very, very thin, great for writing, doing fountain pens on. I got 3 packs of these for, it was like $25. And again, from Goulet Pens, I got two notebooks. It's called Claire Fontaine right here. And these are also used for fountain pens. The paper's a little bit different. It feels a little thicker. And I did a pen writing test on here, you can see. It's a Lamy Safari. That's all I got, Lamy Safari, and a black Lamy Safari ink that I put on there. It's all I wrote on this one. But I really like the way these pens write. And I got two of them from Goulet Pens. So I think that's it. That's all my recent purchases. I'll go into more detail as I start using the fountain pens. Like I said, I just started using these probably, let me see, about a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks ago. I ordered my first one online. It came, and then I ordered another one and another one. And I just, like I said, I started falling in love with them quickly, the way they write. And then I started buying the paper online from the same companies. Same company I got the pens from, except for the one I got from a different company. So I think that's it for right now. I mainly wanted to give you the health update, but also let you know what my recent purchases were. So I hope everybody is doing great, and I'll talk to you soon. Oh, and remember, I'm going to do a complete review on this once I use this for a little while longer, and I'll do a complete review on this on the Keep It Together Fit Life Planner. Okay, thank you, everyone. You all have a good night. Bye for now.